So she married Goebbels. I mean, she was just a pattern of infidelity. Meantime, of course, he was the most unfaithful. I mean, he was the head of things like movie making and so forth. So he kept a casting couch. He laid all the actresses. And incidentally, odd, strange, they all report that he was a most thoughtful and generous lover. But you know, he was a little man, crippled, and so he looked very funny alongside all of those big macho hunks. She was willing to put up with that until he fell in love with a Czech actress named Lida Baarova. She died within the last 6 months, I believe, and she was still just extravagantly beautiful. You just can't imagine how anybody can be 90 and still look that wonderful. Anyway, they fell deeply in love. This wasn't just lay and get out of here business. They were like American teenagers. When he was working late at the office at night, he would leave the telephone open, his telephone off the hook, and she, hers, they would make a phone call and then leave the phone, so they could hear each other breathe. Can you imagine Joseph Goebbels being that sentimental? Just incredible. That his wife would not put up with. And they were going to get married. She, in the meantime, had become attracted to an army officer named Karl Hanke, who was a close friend of Speer's. And Speer also was attracted to her, although I have no idea whether anything happened there. He was going to go with Lida Baarova. Hitler came in and said, "No, you will be a proper Nazi family. This will not happen. You are an example to the public. Cut it out." And they cut it out. Lida Baarova was sent back to Czechoslovakia. Hanke, I think, became, yeah, he was Gauleiter of Breslov. In the last days in the bunker, they sat rocking together, holding hands, like a happily married old couple. That the paradoxes are just so... Meantime, Hanke, if I could just... this doesn't come into my book anywhere, but he was the Gauleiter of Breslov, looking after. As the Russians came in, he was about to surrender, leave it an open city and surrender it to save the city. The man who had been Gauleiter of the city. Hanke came in, saw this, forbid it, and had his friend, the mayor, hanged in public. Then he himself, when the Russians got closer, flew out, saved himself.